known for their defense. And tonight, the linebacker, number 59, Travis Johansson, steps in, picks it off, and he's gone. 49 yards for the touchdown, and just like that, the Bengals are out in front of Maple Grove at home, 7-0. Still in the first, Kyle Savakul hits the field goal from 40 yards away, and Blaine takes a 10-0 lead. Second quarter, Tony George, the quarterback, passes tip, but Stephen Moore is there, makes a nice catch that gives Blaine a first down and keeps the drive alive. It sets up a George keeper, punches it in from a yard out, and Blaine is on their way. Here it comes. First down, George punches it in behind the offensive line, and Blaine is in front. Very comfortable lead. First half clock ticking down. He's going to go to the air. Eric Ables comes down with the ball and the touchdown. Blaine leads 27-0 at halftime. Second half, Maple Grove comes back. Aaron Getchell tries to connect on the TD pass. Whistle for pass interference, Blaine is. So it's first and goal from the one. Ross Mullenberg takes it in from a yard out. It's 27-7. Later, it's Getchell on the keeper. Gets popped to the goal line, but takes it in for the touchdown coming up right here. And now they're down 27-14. Could there be a comeback tonight? Fourth quarter, minute to go. Fourth down, Getchell tries to hit John Hicks. He can't handle it. Blaine wins tonight. 27-14 final. Let's hear from head coach Dave Nelson.
Yeah, we didn't make it easy, though. We're up 27-0 at half. You got to credit Maple Grove. They kept fighting and took advantage of our mistakes. And we found out we got to practice next week. We got some things to work on still.
Defense did a great job. They kept us in the game. They kept the lead for us. And offensively, we just got to step it up a little bit next game. Next week, we got Anoka. That should be a good game again. And just got to step it up offensively and put some points on the board.
Defense was huge. It was huge. They came out in the second half ready to play, and I don't think we did. And they shut us down, so we had to rise back up and shut them down the fourth quarter. And I think we did a good job. Without Deets tonight, I don't could have gone either way.
Wind was blowing hard tonight. Some might say it was out of the east. Eden Prairie quarterback Matt Bykowski tries to go up top to Nick Olson. The ball hangs in the air. Eastview's David Benson picks it off with a nice return. And it sets up seven plays later. The Nings, Jim Colvin, will take it in from 2 yards out. Guess what? Eastview's in front, 6-0. Zap the Lightning mascot likes that, trying to keep Eastview's hopes alive. I'd like to be Zap someday. I'd make a good Zap, I think. Eden Prairie's Greg Betlock, however, takes it in from 19 yards out, leading a second-half comeback. Eden Prairie down 12-0 at halftime, wins tonight. 15-12, that's 41 straight in the lake. Pitches it back to Dave Ugai for a 10-yard run. Nice play by you guy who had a big week last Friday night, and this sets up a touchdown by the Royals. Mark Junt catches the toss, runs it in for the TD, and now White Bear Lake is ahead by only one, 14-13. Less than 2 minutes to go. Here is the winning touchdown pass that keeps Woodbury undefeated. Back to throw. Junt is there, catches it in the end zone, and Woodbury beats White Bear Lake tonight, 19-17 the final. Well, late first half at Buffalo tonight, Irondale's Andrew Partanen to Brian Dahl, 15-yard strike, and Irondale leading 20-7. Are you kidding me? Irondale clobbered Buffalo tonight. Cooper Osby goes in from 10 yards out. It's 30-7. And then watch this play. This team runs the belly option to perfection. Osby goes 43 yards for the score. They crushed Buffalo tonight, 43-7 the final. Big game in Edina tonight. Hopkins and the Hornets, both undefeated. The Royals would score the touchdown on the short yardage play by Bracey, and it makes it 6-3 Hopkins. And their defense would come up big. Brad Hildebrand with the pass, and it's picked off, and the drive is stopped. Hopkins coming up with the play. But late in the game, Edina down 6-3. Watch this catch by Ricky Prestis from Hildebrand. It's the game winner. Edina 9-6 over Hopkins tonight. They're off to a 2-0 start. Edison and Washburn. Washburn's DeCarlos Love. 30-yard gain right in your living room practically as he cuts it back. Big run against Edison. It would set up a field goal by Kurt Keller, who will put it through from 25 yards away, and the Millers take an early 3-0 lead. Washburn's defense comes up big too. Josh Matthews with the sack coming up. And Washburn goes on to win this game tonight, 17-14, to remain undefeated. Minneapolis North at Southwest this afternoon. DeGeorge Tebbs, 28 carries, 138 yards, including this 35-yard scoring run. With a two-point conversion, it's 8-0 North. Tebbs, one of the Metro's best defensive backs, shows why on this play. Picks off the pass, stopping a Southwest drive. But a few plays later, watch the rush by the Lakers, and there's a fumble here. Christoph Schaefer recovers the loose ball in the end zone. It's a touchdown for Southwest, and they're back in the game. It's only 8-6 North when Lamont McGee seals it with a 2-yard scoring run. North wins 16-6 over Southwest this afternoon. If you're a football fan who loves the forward pass, you should have been at Hill-Murray High School. The Pioneers have a quarterback, Brian Kaufman, who last week threw a state record 76 passes in one game. Minnetonka has a quarterback named Dan Berglund. Last week, he threw 47 times in one game. Well, tonight, they both outdid themselves. It was bombs away in Maplewood. Here's Eric Perkins.
Yeah! The first play from scrimmage isn't just a pass, it's a huge gain. Dan Berglund to Jeff Bray for 57 yards, and the skippers of Minnetonka are knocking. A couple passes or plays later, it's Berglund to Bray again. This one for the 11-yard score. Tonka up early via the passing game. But Minnetonka isn't the only passing team out here. Hill-Murray loves the throw, too. Quarterback Brian Kaufman set the state record for pass attempts in a game last week with 76. Sounds like a lot, but his dad, Chuck, says that's nothing.
There's a lot of times I ask him, you know, if his arm gets sore, and he says, no, I throw 200 to 300 balls in practice every day. So he said 70-some is nothing.
So he decided to start tracking just how many passes would be thrown tonight between Minnetonka and Hill-Murray. And these guys were just warming up. Berglund to Teddy Bickle. It's a 25-yard touchdown, 13-0 Minnetonka. The passes keep coming, although they're not always completed, or sometimes they are, but to the other team. Josh Otto takes this one into scoring position for the Pioneers. That's when Kaufman gives his arm a break by running it in from 4 yards out. 13-7 Minnetonka. But then the skippers answer with more aerial. Dan Berglund is considered by many the state's best QB. At 6'4", 212 pounds, he has the perfect build. And by the looks of this TD toss to Teddy Bickle, he's got the arm to back it up. 19-7.
That's 75!
Berglund then hooks up with Jeff Bray again. It's 25-7 Minnetonka.
It's all about the aerial attack. This is insane out here.
These receivers must absolutely love playing in these systems. It's run and gun without the run. And Teddy Bickle has his third touchdown of the game.
Hey, Perk.
Yeah?
I think that was 100.
Was it really?
Yeah, I think so.
I'm almost positive.
Oh, my God!
Oh, my God! In the end, Minnetonka wins 53-41. Both quarterbacks combine for 144 pass attempts, 93 by Hill-Murray's Brian Kaufman. Eric Perkins, Care 11 Sports.
Let me just tell you that Kaufman threw for 656 yards tonight for Hill-Murray. Berglund was 36 for 55 for 340 yards. 1,000 yards of passing offense in one game. 53-41 the final. Let's show you a little bit more of that video tonight because it is an incredible accomplishment tonight in Hill-Murray and a Minnetonka game. This is Eric Perkins' story that he has shared with us tonight, and this is some of the video. Once again, Kaufman tonight for Hill-Murray. 36 completions in 93 attempts for 656 yards. Yeah, Perkins is even calling home to tell us about it. And then Berglund, 36 for 55, 340 yards passing tonight. It is a state record for the most, yes, it is, Eric, believe it or not, a state record for the most pass attempts in one game. And you know what? The yardage may also be a record, 656 yards. I'm sure we'll find out early in the week. But congratulations to both teams and both quarterbacks. Go ice those arms, fellas.